that I have surrendered all that I possess unto your lotus feet, I throw myself down before your house. You are the master of the house. Kindly consider me your own dog. So this kind of love, this kind of helpless sense of surrender to be owned by the master and to be happy because the master is happy, to see one's mission in life to serve the master. The prayer has referred to the dog who has such good qualities in relation to the master. If we could somehow achieve this self sacrifice to the lotus feet of our spiritual master, to the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if we could become the servant, then only we would begin to taste the true joy that the jiva is meant for. Instead of pretending in a role that we can never enjoy, pretending that we are the master, that we have the house, that we have the right, the adhikar, when we have nothing, we're fools in this world, dancing like puppets to the modes of material nature and the dictates of our cruel senses and our delusion mind, making a fool and a miserable existence out of this human life. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is expressing a level of purity of love, a level of surrender, which is amazing. And the analogy of the dog is very apt, of course. The dog is teaching us the absolute loyalty. Dog becomes happy when the master is happy, when the master comes home. He thinks all day, when is the master coming? I am guarding his house. I'm keeping the mischievous away. Next one. Chaining me nearby, again, the analogy of the dog. You will maintain me. I shall lie at your doorstep. Like the dog, he doesn't eat unless the master feeds him. If the master abuses him, just like Mahaprabhu has said, even if you handle me roughly by your embrace, or you make me brokenhearted by not being present before me, still, and the just like the dog, he never gives up loyalty to the master. He's always eager to hear the footsteps of the master coming, even after days, even after weeks, even after years. Sometimes we hear of the dog whose master has died, and he sits waiting patiently to hear the footsteps again of his master. And so this is the mood of surrender that brings us everything, because it brings us back to the correct position to be the servant of the servant of the servant, with no desire for prestige of any kind, and no thought of our own satisfaction. Rather, by love, one seeks the satisfaction of the beloved. Oh, this is pure love. This is pure Krishna Prem. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has been so kind to put this sweet mood within this beautiful prayer so that we can somehow taste a little bit and perhaps remember and become inspired to go in that direction. Hare Krishna. The food that we eat becomes our daily sustenance. It makes our being, it forms our body. They say that you are what you eat. So let me feast only on those remnants that are given from the Lord, from his Mahaprasadam, from the devotees of the Lord, and let them give me whatever they please. I remember when Srila Prabhupada used to, after he finished his plate of prasadam, the senior devotees would all wait in Mayapur for the remnants. And the cook, my wife was cooking, she would bring out those remnants. And each sannyasi would look at the plate and say, oh, I want one of these. Oh, give me one of these. Oh, I'll take this sweet. No, I'll take this puri. And she wasn't very happy with that mood. So she said to Srila Prabhupada, I'm having a problem. Everybody's taking a different... And Prabhupada, without listening to the full sentence, he interrupted. He said, just mix it all together. And she was very happy with that. So she would just smear it all together, sweets and karela and rice and everything smeared together. And then when the sannyasis came, oh, they would just take a little spoon. And then she would sit in the back of the kitchen and eat fully to her heart's content. So Raghunath Das Goswami used to take just the leftover rice that was thrown out of the pot in the back. He used to gather it. Because the goal of the devotee is not to continue to maintain this material existence. The goal of the devotee is to get the taste of bhakti. And just the touching of the mouth of the Lord or the Lord's devotees, it infuses that bhoga, that food, with the love. So any contact that we can have with the Lord and his devotees will hopefully infect us with devotion. And that is the only goal of life. That is the only goal of life. So here the devotee, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, is praying for even that sustenance, that food which holds the body, the soul together, that it only should come from the devotees of the Lord and the Lord, and that only he'll take. Hare Krishna. And the mind is the most difficult problem. It's always going here and there. It's never thinking properly. This mind is a source of great torture for the devotee endeavoring on the path of bhakti. Because it's always chanchala, it's always disloyal. But here, this analogy running through the entire prayer of the dog, this should be the standard for the mind, that the dog's mentality of waiting only for the master, thinking only of the master, while he's lying down, he's dreaming. Huh? Even the dog, when the dog is dreaming, sometimes you'll see if the dog is lying, he'll make some sounds. He'll move, his eyes will move behind the closed lids. And he's actually dreaming. And he's only dreaming of one thing. He doesn't dream about, oh, I think I'll run down the street and chase the other dogs. And he's dreaming, when will the master come home? When will the master smile on me? When will the master be here so I can serve him? This is the mood of the dog. So even lying down, I remember sitting with Srila Prabhupada in his room in Vrindavan while he was sleeping, supposedly sleeping. In the middle of the night, he was lying down with his eyes closed, his hands crossed on his chest, and about 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning, the peacocks all started to call across Vrindavan. Across Vrindavan. And the Brajbasis used to tell me that the peacocks are calling Sri Radha. They're calling a name of Sri Radha. Of course they are. It's Vrindavan. What else would they call? So when Prabhupada heard this peacock call, he started to moan, oh, oh, like this. His head was turning back and forth. So you could see that at every moment, he was instantly drawn into every sound, into every stimulation that would bring him closer to Krishna. And every word he saw as an opportunity to serve his Lord. When he was lying there waiting to depart, I remember the devotees came from New Vrindavan and they said, Srila Prabhupada, look at this beautiful palace we've made for you. You come and live here. And Prabhupada said, we will see which palace Krishna wants me to live in. So always confident that his master would care for him and never concerned with what that standard would be, whether he had to go back to hell and save some more conditioned souls, or whether Krishna wanted him to live in some palace in Dwarka or wherever he wanted him. But he would always be the servant. We asked Srila Prabhupada in those days, will we be with you in the spiritual world, Srila Prabhupada? And Prabhupada said, when we go back to Goloka Vrindavan, he said, the residents of Vaikuntha will fly by in their airplanes, their flower airplanes, and they'll look down on us and they'll say, oh, look at the nice guru and his disciples. So it's to be understood that this family will stay together forever, and all of us can fully surrender with confidence. Srila Rupa Goswami instructs us to have confidence that someday Krishna will save us. So with that confidence, you can give up all concern for yourself. Be fully confident that the master will take care. Huh? Everyone is taken care of. Prabhupada tells even the birds are fed. Even the chipmunk squirrels are running around there. Everyone's fed. Everyone's cared for. And as soon as you come into the family of Vaishnavas, under the shelter of Krishna, do you have any problem with food? We do have a problem with food. I have a very big problem with it. There's so much food, I can't. This is my problem with food. Huh? There's so much kindness. There's so much joy. There's so much nourishment. Huh? There's so much of everything. We should be confident that Krishna will save us. Hmm? And I will never think for my own nourishment, and I will remain absorbed in ever-cherishing love for my master. Bhakti Vinod now accepts you as his only maintainer. No more scheming, organizing, plotting, just accepting what the Lord brings us. This is the height of Krishna consciousness. It seems to the mind impractical, perhaps impossible, but it is possible and it is very practical. Srila Prabhupada is ready to feed the whole world. We remember, he never hesitated. He never thought, oh, too many people are coming to the feast, what will we do? Oh my God, so many devotees in the temple, how will we pay? No, he said, come on, bring everyone. I'll feed everyone. He was prepared because he knew that the Lord was prepared to care for everyone. He had that confidence. And in fact, in Prabhupada's presence, it was like Queen Kunti with her magic plate. There was never a shortage. There was always more. There was always unlimited. Everyone felt happy. We would crowd into a small house to see Srila Prabhupada or to do service, to do seva. And that small house was like a palace. You'd find some devotees sleeping in the closet And you think, oh my God, what a horrible fate. No, that devotee was so happy, so joyful, because of this Sharanagati, this mood that Srila Prabhupada could spark in us. So we should keep this fully alive and take full shelter of the holy name of Krishna. The holy name of Krishna is Krishna in the most kind form, reaching down to us in this hellish condition. The holy name appears on the horizon like the sun to illuminate our life, to illuminate our day. And if we take shelter of the sunshine of the holy name, then all of the saints, all of the shastras, all of the words of the Supreme Personality of Godhead all confirm that we'll not be the loser. We'll get that shelter. We must have that confidence. Take that leap. We take so many leaps in life. We try as a baby to stand up. Suddenly we lunge forward. The first leg goes forward. We don't know if we'll fall flat on our face. But at some point we try. We give some confidence. And then step by step throughout life, we take so many leaps forward. So take this one leap, Srila Prabhupada has advised us. Just this one lifetime, give your whole life to Krishna and you'll not be the loser. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Bol. Okay, so this next gong is called Shuddha Bhakata. So do you have control of this thing? So it works now? Okay. So I'm going to read through it first. So this means dust from the lotus feet of pure devotees is conducive to devotional service, while service to the Vaishnavas is itself the supreme perfection, as well as the root of the tender creeper of divine love. I observe with great care the holy days, commemorating the pastimes of Lord Madhava, for they are the mother of devotion. As my dwelling place, I choose with the greatest of reverence and love the transcendental abode of Sri Krishna. So you see, these are very practical things in this song. Right? A lot of times we speak about the esoteric love and devotion and all these things, but this is very practical terms Srila Bhaktivinoda is putting it in. Right? The dust of the lotus feet, this is conducive to devotional service. That's very practical. Service to the Vaishnavas, right? Observing the holy days, all these things, very practical. Next. So all those places where my Lord Gaurasundar traveled for pastimes, I will visit in the company of loving devotees. So my mind ever longs for the opportunity to hear the music of the mridanga. Upon hearing the kind of kirtan ordained by Lord Gaurachandra, my heart dances in ecstasy. Still very practical. The sound of the mridanga, especially the big head, that's said to drive away all these material desires. Boom, yeah, see? My mind ever longs for the opportunity to hear the music. Oh, we already read that. So beholding the deity forms of the divine couple, Sri Sri Radha Krishna, I feel the greatest joy. By honoring the Lord's prasad, I conquer over all worldly illusions. Right, sarira avijijao dutendiya taika jivevasagare. We recite that prayer before we eat, right? How do we conquer the tongue? By engaging it in the service of Krishna. Tongue has two particular activities. One is to vibrate and one is to taste. So very easy to dovetail in the service of Krishna by vibrating his holy name and tasting his prasad. Very practical. instructions by Bhaktivinoda. So Goloka Vrindavan appears in my home whenever I see the worship service of the Lord Hari taking place there. When I see the Ganga, that river of nectar emanating from the lotus feet of the Lord, my happiness knows no bounds. The sight of the holy Tulsi tree soothes my soul, for I know she gives pleasure to Lord Madhava. By tasting the green leafy preparation named Shak, a great favorite of Lord Gauranga's, I consider life worthwhile. Whatever Bhaktivinoda obtains that is favorable for the service of Sri Krishna, he accepts every day with the greatest joy. Jai. Okay, go back to the beginning. Shuddha bhakta charana renu bhajana anakula. Shuddha bhakta charana renu bhajana anakula. Bhakata seva paramasiddhi premalatika mula. Madhava titi bhakti janani jatane palana kori. Krishna vasati vasati bod parama adhari bodhi. Goramaraye sabastane korolo brahmana range. Se sabastana hirevami pranayi bhakata sange. Mridanga vadya shunite man abhasara sada yache. Gora vihita kirtana shuni anande hridoy nache. Gala murti dekhiya mora parama ananda hoya. Prasada seva korite hoya sakala prapancha jaya. Yedina grihe bhajana deke grihete goloka vaya. Yedina Charanasi dhudekiya ganga shukanasima paya. Tulasi deki juraya prana madhava toshani jani. Pia sakasevane jivana sartakamani. Bhakati vinara Krishna bhajane nakula paya jaha. Prati devase paramasuke svikara koro yeta. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Oh, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Oh! Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Gaura Premanandi, Hare Hare Bol. Hare Krishna. So whatever power does the name of Krishna possess? That's a question. Anybody know? Nam namakari bahuda nija sarva shaktis. You know that verse? Huh? Nam namakari bahuda nija sarva shaktis. Whatever power does the name of Krishna possess? All the powers that Krishna possess. Eh? Nam namakari bahuda nija sarva, sarva shaktis, all the energy of Krishna is within his name because it's not different from Krishna. His name and Krishna are the same. So my heart constantly burns in the fire of worldly rays of the sun. Whew, what an analogy, right? You've all seen a desert where the sun is just, you know, desert is like that because it's always sunny. I think the average rainfall in the in Death Valley, which is in Nevada, there, California, Nevada area, is about 0.1% of an inch a year or something like that. So the sun is just shining all the time. And when this, you know how devastating the sun is, it dries everything up. So he's saying that my heart constantly burns in the fire of worldly desires. So the analogies that these great devotees make are so far out. I guess that's about the word I could describe it. You know, to think that my desires are, they're burning so much, they're like the desert sun. Right? So the holy name entering the core of my heart through the holes of my ears showers unparalleled nectar upon my soul. So you can see that although their worldly desires, claiming there are so many worldly desires, it's just like the fire of the rays of the sun in the desert, still, the holy name of Krishna is so potent and so powerful that it can still shower nectar upon the soul which resides in the heart. The nature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Next. So the holy name speaks from within my heart, moves onto the tip of my tongue, and constantly dances on it in the form of transcendental sound. My throat becomes choked up, my body violently shivers, and my feet cannot remain still. You hear that part? My feet cannot remain still? That means when the kirtan is going, we dance. Prabhupada said there's three austerities for this age. Anybody know what they are? Chanting, dancing, and taking prasadam, right? And what kind of austerity is that? When we think of austerity, we think of a yogi who sits in a freezing cold river up to his neck for days at a time, right? Or we think of Vishwamitra, right? He was at the bottom of the ocean for 50,000 years or something like that. Yeah. Or someone surrounds them, you know, builds all these fires, and then he sits in the middle in the blazing hot sun. You know, we think those are austerities. But the real austerity for this age is to chant, to dance, and to take prasadam. Next. Where are we? Is that it? Okay, rivers of tears flow from my eyes. Perspiration completely soaks my body. All my skin thrills with rapture. My hairs stand on end, and my complexion turns pale and discolored. My mind grows faint. I begin to experience devastation, and my entire body is shattered in a flood of ecstatic emotions. Now, these are the symptoms that the body creates when we're in this devotional ecstasy by chanting the holy name. This is also mentioned in the Shikshashtakam. But at the same time, Prabhupada says, one who chants the name of Krishna, who recites or says the name of Krishna, that's not an ordinary person. That's not an ordinary person. It's considered that that person has performed heaps of pious activities somewhere along the line in the 8,400,000 species of life that we've been. So we just can feel ourselves very fortunate to be able to chant Hare Krishna and continually pray for that that's sanctioned by the Lord to be able to chant his holy name, because that's the most fortunate person. The demigods are looking down upon the devotees in envy, seeing that they're chanting Hare Krishna, they're going back home just like this, just so easily. So they're looking, so we're in a very, very fortunate position. Next. While causing such an ecstatic disturbance, the holy name showers liquid nectar on my heart and drowns me in the ocean of divine love of Godhead. He does not allow me to understand anything, for he has made me truly mad by having stolen away my mind and all my resources. See, this is the process of chanting, as I understand it here, is that all we have to do is hear the holy name. We just hear it. We don't have to concoct a whole bunch of things in our mind. We don't have to start thinking of gopis and thinking of cowherd boys, thinking of Vrindavan, thinking of anything. We don't have to think of anything. We just have to hear the holy name of Krishna. And that holy name will do everything. Devotees ask Prabhupada, they say, Prabhupada, what should we think of? Should we think of, Prabhupada said, just hear the holy name, and these things will automatically come, right? When Valmiki, he was chanting Mara, 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 right? And then it turned to Ram, 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 Ram. He was just thinking of the name, and all the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra came to him from the name. Because If Krishna is non-different from his name, then everything is there within the name. Krishna, his paraphernalia, his associates, his pastimes, everything. Next. Such is the behavior of him in whom I have taken shelter. I am not capable of describing all this. The holy name of Krishna is independent and thus acts on his own sweet will. In whatever way he becomes happy, that is also my way of happiness. So again, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is completely independent. We are completely dependent. Right? He is completely the Supreme. And we are the subordinate. We are his servants. So that's what that means. So when the master is happy, then the servant is happy. We have the very practical and easy to understand example of watering the root of the tree, or the other example of feeding the stomach. Right? We don't put food in our hand and try to squish it and become nourished. Right? The people that stomp on the grapes to make wine, they're not nourished by that, but it doesn't go in their feet and then nourish, oh, they feel energized. Right? No, we have to put it in the stomach, put it in the mouth, and the mouth works to put it in the stomach. And then it's sent throughout the entire body, and the entire body is nourished. We water the root of the tree, then the nourishment for the whole tree is sent by this system. So similarly, Krishna is the supreme. He's the root cause of all causes. He's the cause of us. And therefore, when we serve him, then we are served. You want to serve yourself? Serve Krishna. Then you're automatically served. Yes. So the holy name is the bud of the flower of divine love and is the very abode of astonishing mellows. Such is the power he manifests that when his holy name starts to blossom a little further, it then reveals his own divine form and qualities. Thus, my heart is abducted and taken directly to Krishna. So the same theme is there, that the holy name is going to take care of everything for us. The holy name is going to have these things develop within us. It will awaken our original love for Krishna. And from that love, the divine form will be revealed, and the qualities of the divine qualities. We cannot develop these understandings simply from the mental platform or even the intellectual platform. What to speak of the sensual platform? No, we surrender under Krishna and he reveals himself. Right? That's his right. He's the supreme. And thus, my heart is abducted, Hare Krishna, and taken directly to Krishna. Right? What does Lord Chaitanya pray? That he would like to be one of the stita duli, one of the atoms, a dust, a particle of dust at the lotus feet of Krishna. That's called stita duli. The stita duli, the atoms of dust that are on the lotus feet of Krishna, are living entities who have done such great service to Krishna to be able to have that position. So Lord Chaitanya is praying, let me be one of these dust at the atom of your lotus feet. This, they're described in the Bhagavatam, stuta duli, stita duli. Next. Is there a next? That's it? No, the name of Krishna is a transcendental touchstone, a mine of all devotional mellows. It is eternally liberated and the embodiment of pure rasa. When all impediments to the pure chanting of the holy name are taken away and destroyed, then my happiness will know its true awakening. Just like today is a very cloudy, rainy day, so we can't take much benefit from the sun. Although the sun is there shining, if you were flying somewhere, you'd get in an airplane and you'd fly through these clouds and above the clouds, and there where the sun would be shining. So it's not that the holy name is not bestowing all the time. It's benedictions upon us, but we have these, what does it say, impediments. Right? We create the impediments for the Holy Name to do its work, not the Holy Name. Holy Name is pure, complete. Next. Is there next? That's it. Hare Krishna.
Krishna Naam Dhare Krishna Dhare Ko Toba Krishna Naam Dhare Ko Toba
Krishna Naam Dhare Ko Toba
Vishaya Vasana Nale Mora Chitta Sada jale
Jaya Vasanale Morachita Sada jale
Vishaya Vasanale Morachita Sada jale Ravi tapta maru bhumi sa Karna randra patha diya hrudi majhe praveshiya Varishai Sudanupam Hridaya hoite bole Jivara agrate chale Shabda rupe nache anukshat Kante mora bange shara Anga kanpe tara tara Tira hoite na pare chara Chakshe dhara dehe garma Pulakita shaba charma Vivarna hoilo kalevar भावे सर्वदेहा जरा जा कोरिए तो उपद्रव चित्ते वशे सुदाद्रव मोरे दारे प्रेमे रासागारे किछु ना भुजिते Chintamani akila rase rakhani Krishna nama chintamani akila rase rakhani Nitya mukta shuddha rasama Nitya mukta shuddha rasama Tabe mora shukera udar Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna
So everybody take their, how about the ladies, you? Okay, there's one line, two lines, three lines. Ladies aren't as coordinated, come on. Somebody right here. No. Now take your right arm and stretch it out like that. Yeah, no, just, no, right arm. All right, okay, so now we need another line. Are you gonna join us? No, why not? We're going to chant Hare Krishna in this exercise, yes. So please, ladies, you're going to join? Everybody have their bead bag? Yes. Don't be shy. There's no false ego here. Okay, we need another line, though. We need some more ladies in this line. Please. Yeah, some more. Some of you from the back, please take this line here. So we got 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. 2, 4, 6. So you have to go there. Okay. Okay, now the outside lines will turn to the inside, and the inside lines will turn to the outside. Right? You're going to turn that way. You're going to turn that way. You're same with the ladies. Now, you all have someone across from you, right? Does everybody, anyone not have someone across for them? So whoever's across from you, that's your partner for this exercise. Is it all the ladies, you have someone across from you? Okay. So now what we're going to do is, generally speaking, the Maha Mantra, I was just reading this by Prabhupada the other day, the Maha Mantra, although it can be recited out loud, loudly, or silently, generally speaking, it should be recited out loud. So generally, japa is chanted just so someone else could hear it. That's about how loud. You know, now if your mind is really giving you trouble, then you may want to shout it out. But you should probably go somewhere else rather than disturb everybody. But it's not really chanted. Although the mantra can be chanted in the mind, japa is not really meant for in the mind chanting, except maybe for those very, very pure souls. That I, you know, if you're that in that case, please forgive me. But for this exercise, we're going to chant loud enough so that our partner can hear us, because our partner is going to listen to us and see how we are chanting the mantra. The mantra has 16 words, right? And each of those words has two syllables, correct? That means 32 syllables. Prabhupada very often criticized devotees for you know, stuff like that. Yeah. That's not how the mantra should be chanted. It should be enunciated very clearly, because again, the whole idea is to just hear the holy name of Krishna. And the holy name of Krishna is has all the potency of Krishna. So you can sit down together, you can do whatever you like together, but that's where we're going to do one round. You can choose, let's say, those in this line will chant first, those in this line will chant first, right? So those in this outside line will chant first, and those on this line will chant first. And so you'll chant so that she can listen to you, because the process is shravanam kirtanam, right? Hearing and chanting, just like when we do kirtan. Sometimes some people think, well, we're going to chant all the time. But really, the whole process is you hear the leader, and then you sing it back so he can hear you. That's the process of kirtan. So that's what we're going to do for this exercise. So this will take, this first part of this line and that line chanting should take about 10 minutes is about what a round should take. So it'll give you 10, 12 minutes or something like that to chant your round. Okay? So you can begin. You can sit down. You don't have to stay right here. But, you know, I'll let you know when the time is done. Now, the only talking necessary is the Hare Krishna mantra. Just remember, in this exercise, there's no false ego. So that means if you can't hear your partner, then please ask them to chant slightly louder so that you can hear. Hare Krishna. So that's been a little over 10 minutes. Most everyone's done one round? Yeah? Okay. We won't comment till after the other side has done. Now the other side will chant. And the first side will listen. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. So this was a little unexpected to have the deities, because now that we've done this, we wanted to kind of talk about the experience a little bit. So maybe we could do that anyway. Was this experience of chanting with someone else listening different than your normal japa? Anybody?
Yes?
Yes? So what was different about that experience? Huh? Why were you listening? So, yes, sir. So they seem to be saying that they were more conscious of their chanting because someone else was listening. Anybody have that same experience? Most of you? Yeah. Well, whenever you're chanting your japa, someone else is listening. Krishna is dancing on your tongue, so he's listening, right? So never think that you're alone. This is a very good experience. Now, but I hope you weren't shy if you heard some problem in someone's chanting, like they were omitting a word here or there, or it kind of blurred together or something like that. It's a very difficult thing to tell somebody that, because it's a very personal thing to chant your japa. But it's very beneficial for that person. It's very beneficial for them to hear about it. So please don't, you know, in all humility, you say, Prabhu, you know, you were chanting three extra Haris, you know, or it was just Krishan or something like that. It wasn't complete. It's very, very, because, you know, that's why we chant a whole round, because we figure, well, the first part half of the round, we're feeling like somebody's listening, I got to really chant nicely. But maybe by the end of the round, we're back to our old habits, you know? So it's really good to have someone do this. Even every once in a while, if you want to do this on your own, you find someone, Prabhu, could you please listen to my chanting? It's a very humbling position, because we normally think that we're doing everything perfect. What to speak of chanting Hare Krishna, we think we're doing that perfect. But we find sometimes if we have someone listen to it, you know, that number one, we perk up because we think someone's listening. And number two, we may come around to that point where we fall back into our old habits and it can be pointed out. This is a friend, a true friend will help guide you and will point out, right? My wife, she's always telling me what's wrong with me. You know, we've been married 48 years, something like that. And so, you know, after 25 years, that's when you start to love someone. It takes 25 years. So, you know, and then they'll tell you anything. You know, once they'll tell, yeah, you have bad breath, or you have this, or, you know, you're not doing this right, you're not doing that right. But this, you know, it's a very humbling position, but it's very helpful at the same time. Because, you know, even though I remember, oh, you know, I shouldn't leave the lid up in the bathroom, you know, because that's something your wife is always telling you not to do, right? So you kind of resent that when she tells you. But, you know, later on you remember, oh, yeah, I better put the lid down. You know, that's polite. It's nice. It's clean. So, you know, it may be a far distant analogy from chanting, but the principle is the same, that we can always learn, right? Learn something new every day. That's what we do. So please take this into account in your chanting, and thank you very much for performing this exercise, and good luck in chanting. Hare Krishna. Really just needs to be done.